parties and I've thrown. I've never been enchanted by a female yet.
Never?
Yes.
Are you sure about that? Like, ever? Never,
yeah,
ever?
No, it's. I've been kind of preoccupied with. I really hate to do this.
Do what?
Because, you know, the ladies find it hard to resist me being an Oxford graduate and war hero. And the handsome son of a gun I am.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely.
I am definitely the bee's knees.
Yes, you are.
I like your cousin.
My
bisexual.
My cousin.
Yeah. Rose, I like Rose.
Oh, Rose. Okay, I thought you were talking about.
Okay, is it okay if I go for her?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Do you think that she'll like? Cause me and her used to have a thing.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
She never told me that.
Yeah, it was real fiery, but. You think she would leave her?
I mean, you're from Oxford, right?
Yeah, I just want to dance. I want to dance with her.
What kind of dance, like?
You know what? Your hair looks too plain, my friend.
Looks too
plain? It's 1926. You have to use pomade.
What? What's pomade?
The best way I could describe it is mud for your hair.
Mud?
Now, I would think you only use a little, because that would look stylish, but apparently these days you just...
Do you just put it...
Let's start.
Are you going to put it on?
Yeah. No, I'm going to put it on me. I'll show you.
Oh, okay.
I'll show you.
So you're devastated.
This is my first time doing this. I literally read this in a book yesterday. I bought this today for the party, and This seems like too much.
It kind of looks like you're putting like jelly, like...
Yeah. On your hair. Maybe, but the ladies apparently like this.
Oh, they do?
So, is this supposed to make that sound?
Wait, do they? It smells like oranges.
See, if you get a bunch in there like this, See, if I hold it up to the mirror, you can see. But, you know, you just...
So, does it help with your looks?
Just hold your hair back. You know, I've been reading this dude, F. Scott Fitzgerald. Mm-hmm. He's magnificent.
The one that made, what's the...
That cat speak?
Bat
speak?
Bat speak?
That one, right?
Right.
I heard also that there's a new symphony called Broccoli.
Broccoli?
Yes.
Like the food you eat?
Yes, like... I heard it's the beginning.
There's gonna be, what's his name?
Brother Chaz.
Brother Chaz, yeah.
The great brother.
What do you know about him?
I actually don't know much. I know that he's obsessed with music and he's very stuck up.
Really? I've heard otherwise.
What have you heard?
That he's super handsome and rich and dreamy.
Where did you hear that from?
People. Everyone knows him.
I don't know, I'm kind of interested in his friend.
Which one? Tell me the deets.
No, that's dirty. We'll talk about it later.
Well, me and Tina, to tell you the truth, are having some issues, so I'm kind of interested in the great Chaz.
What kind of issues?
Hello, guys.
Tina.
Hello.
Hi, darling.
You ready for tonight?
Yes, of course.
Hello. Are you ready?
Yeah. You're gonna get ready with us?
Yeah, definitely.
All right.
We were just talking about how excited we are for the party tonight.
Me too.
Oh, what are you going to wear? Are you wearing that dress?
Yes. What are you guys going to wear?
Is this too fancy? Maybe with a little shawl on.
I would never wear anything that fancy.
You know me, I'm over the top.
I don't like dresses. I guess it's fine if you want to catch Tina's attention.
Definitely, yeah.
So, shall we get going?
Of course, we don't want to be late.
Let's go, girls.
Idea for this book.
Book, alright. Shoot it.
Bat guy.
Bat guy.
Bat guy. Like bat. B-A-T. Bat kinda, guy. Kinda bat
like,
guy.
Like, how's like, bad guy?
Bat. No, he's not a bad guy. He's the good guy, but he's bat guy.
It kind of sounds like he's a bad guy. Alright. Calm down. You can't have her looking at you like this.
It's rough!
Okay, calm down.
It's rough!
Come on, you had too much to drink.
You know what? I went to Oxford.
Yes,
I'm a war hero, as far as you know.
Yes, you are.
Oh, fine. I own real books, for God's sake.
Hello, Chaz.
I'll always kiss a woman's hand, but when you look like that?
Handsomely, much more than handsomely. It was one of those rare smiles with a quality of eternal reassurance in it that you may come across four or five times in a life. It faced, or seemed to face, the whole external world for an instant, and then concentrated on you with an irresistible prejudice in your favor. It understood you just as far as it wanted to be understood. I was looking at an elegant young roughneck, a year or two over 30, whose elaborate formality of speech just missed being absurd. Sometime before he introduced himself.
You like cars, and this is my big car. Is it big enough? Sometimes they tell me it's not big enough, and I feel bad because I want a bigger car, but it's the car that I have. What am I supposed to
do? It's nice.
I love you.
And in that moment when I swooped her down like a dead body in a body bag, I knew she was mine. She was all mine. I felt her warmth like a chicken pot pie, caressing my face. And I knew in that moment that I'd wish I had done everything on earth with her. Everything at all possible. Blah, 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 blah.